Why hello there guys, Qwerty Afro here. Welcome back to OMSI 2. It has been, what, I don't know, 5-6 months since my last OMSI 2 video. Do I regret not doing any OMSI videos for that time that has passed? No, I don't. Sorry. I really do not. Like, I wish I really don't have to be involved with this game anymore, but OMSI London is coming out really soon and I'm really excited for that, and that's the only thing that's keeping me interested in this game, because this game has just boiled my blood too much over the years. I've done what, something like 42 OMSI 2 videos and OMSI the number one videos as well, like in combination, and I think it got to 42, and it wasn't that I stopped and I just was like, oh, I'm not doing any more videos. I was trying to do videos. I had like 3 or 4 videos I was recording simultaneously to do, to upload back then in August when the last one was that I did. And I just ran into so many problems with like crashes, bugs, glitches, buses not working, maps not working, just things just not working in general for OMSI, and I just said to myself, no, I can't be bothered to just give this this game any more of my energy, because it's just too much, and it boiled my blood too much, and I got to the point where I needed a break, and I'm glad I went on this hiatus. It's actually quite a long one. It's almost half a year that I've not actually done an OMSI video, and it's flown by, like if I actually kind of think about it, but I do not regret it. I'm back because the OMSI London Addon is coming out really soon. Don't ask me for a date because I don't know one. Only one that really knows a date is Reese, the developer. Do not ask me, first of all, where to get this bus from, or the skin for this bus, or anything related to this bus, because this bus, I'm luckily showcasing it to you because I'm beta test obviously with the OMSI London crew, and this is in work in progress still. This is the beta version of the Gemini 3, the Volvo Wright Bus Gemini 3, or it will be called in the map the Citybus G3 or Gemini 3 or Citybus 3, I'm not too sure. But the whole thing with Citybus is obviously because there's been any kind of copyright. I think there's copyright over the kind of like calling the bus after the company's name. So like Enviro 400 would be called Citybus 400 because of copyright issues and whatnot. So it's Citybus is the kind of company that makes the buses in the OMSI London kind of world add-on. So that's why it's called Citybus. That's not why it's called its actual name, but we all know what it is. It is a Volvo Wright Bus Gemini 3 BHLF, BLHF 5, something, I don't know, forgive me, it'll be in the title anyway, but, you know, I'm still getting back into OMSI. This is a sort of a semi-comeback, not really the full-on comeback where I'll be just making OMSI videos all the time, no. I'm on a map that I've just recently actually gotten to work is Buses of the West Country version 2.7, the version 2.7 patch. I realized that there were certain files that I needed to have, and I got those, and now the map works, so I'm very happy. There is one route on this map, which is Route 35, and we're going to be driving today on one of the legs from Totnes train station to Paignton train station, and then we're going to, in another video, I'm going to do the return leg, and in the return leg, I'm actually going to have a look, finally, at the Citybus 400R, or the Enviro 400R, which was released as a public release at the end of last year, and I'm going to do that as a return leg journey, and that's like a full released bus and whatnot. This, however, is a beta version, it's work in progress still. This is not a representation of the final product that you guys will be seeing in the OMSI London add-on map, so just keep that in mind. Things still need to be added to this bus. There are probably still bugs and glitches and whatnot with this bus. It's not the full completed bus that will be in the add-on, in the payware add-on that you guys will hopefully get once it comes out. But it's back. It's good to be back in OMSI, sort of, I guess, because I have nice buses to drive like this, because I'm luckily a beta tester, even though I've not really been doing much beta testing because I've not had any time, but I'll definitely give a bit of exposure and showcase some of the work that Reese and the development team have been doing on on this map and with the buses and whatnot. This Gemini 3 replaces, I do believe, the SRM bus. I think the SRM will be at some point later in the stage of the cycle. I think it might be implemented in as a patch or as an add-on itself. I don't know. I don't know what's going to be about, because I think the SRM was built, but I think they decided to go with the Gemini 3 as a more of a better kind of like release date bus. More than the SRM, which is a very rare bus, and it's not like a common bus you see on most lines in London. It's like on maybe two or three lines, and there's only like four or five buses of the actual SRM variant. But let's get involved. Let's do this. I've set up everything in terms of timetable. I've put on the destination things. I don't think the destination blinds work on this map. It doesn't show 35 to Paignton. I think it works on Cotterell. There are other liveries available for this bus. I'm currently using the London Sovereign livery, which the reason why I wanted to use it, or even the London United, because they're pretty much the same livery, is because it's makes the bus all red, pretty much. Most of the other liveries, like Metro Line and Tower Transit, etc., have the kind of like black etchings around the lower part of the windows. All around here to the back would be kind of all black, but on the London Sovereign and London United liveries, you get a kind of more red kind of look. And obviously at the front here, the most noticeable difference is the lights are not etched in black. I'm guessing plastic or metal. What it is in real life, I don't know, but it's actually etched in red, which is nice. It makes it look very odd. I've seen these all red ones in London, and they look very, very odd. So that's why I thought I'd have a play in this one instead of any of the other liveries. But if you guys want me to do any of the other liveries, say on like Cotterell, I could do another video on Cotterell with this bus. If you guys want me to, then maybe I could do it in another livery. You can pick that livery. Tell me your thoughts in the comments. Maybe one that gets the highest upvotes of like what livery I should do. I think there's like Tower Transit, Stagecoach, Metro Line, Abellio London, Arriva, Abellio, Arriva London. There is London, Go Ahead London General. There's a Go Ahead London General, the older livery. And there's a few more, but whatnot. But, you know, the kind of normal common bus operating company liveries that you would expect in London and whatnot. Anyway, let's get involved here. The shoutouts for the video go to DurpyPigGaming and Howach. That's again DurpyPigGaming and Howach. Their links and stuff will be down below. Do stay tuned in this video as well, because I'm going to be explaining what I'm going to be doing in terms of shoutouts for future shoutouts, as well as requests and submissions and stuff for ideas for videos and whatnot. One thing to also include, the link down will be down below if you want to get any information, and the best place to keep up to date with information of the development of the OMSI London add-on, as well as when the release date will be, any kind of information with like buses or like map information, etc., just anything in the whole development cycle. The best place to keep up to information with is the Facebook page, the OMSI London Facebook page. Be sure to give it a like on Facebook. I'll leave the link down below. That's the best place you're going to get any sort of information. This video is not going to be the best place to get information. I'm just showcasing a beta bus that's in work in progress still, and just showing you just the kind of stuff that you can expect in the actual add-on. And because I'm allowed to, so why not? Let's get the electrics on. And let's actually go outside and hear this engine, because it's actually not too bad. Not bad. Nice bit of a startup. Not too shabby. It's not the most, like, amazing, vigorous engine that's going to just, like, literally rip off your sheets when you wake up in the morning, but... Well, it probably would, actually, but you know what I mean. It's not the most kind of, like, you know, aggressive engine. But obviously these engines now, the Euro 6 engine and whatnot, they're so eco-friendly and whatnot. They just been toned down so much for what we have known from, like, past engines and whatnot. I have my G29 plugged up. I'm not going to use Track IR, because I found Track IR has fiddles with the FPS for some reason. And when I'm in the cab and I use Track IR, the FPS around this map, or I don't know, I've not tried it on any other maps, but this map and with this bus particularly, just the FPS goes a bit weird when I use Track IR. So I'm going to just not use Track IR, and I'm just going to use my steering wheel and drive, and I might just switch the cameras like this with my keyboard, so I hope you guys don't mind that, but I think the steering's more important when I have my steering wheel, but truck arm, yeah, okay. I'm just not going to use it for this bus. Let's put on the low beams, because I do like having low beams on pretty much every bus and whatnot. Let's get the... And one thing to do, actually, is turn on the directions. And let's rev this bus up and then get into drive. That is a kind of funny way of accelerating in this bus, where you just you rev it up in neutral and then you slot it into drive. But don't worry, that's a bit of a like a little bug of an issue that the testers have been told how to kind of like use the bus in terms of like making it like start up, because I think there's an issue where if you accelerate, it doesn't accelerate initially, so you have to rev it up in neutral and then switch it into drive to kind of like go instantly. And that's fine. I'm not too. That'll most likely be fixed for the actual release and whatnot. There we go, everyone on. You heard the actual oyster tapping machine kind of thing, the ticker machine, which will be implemented as well for OMSI London and whatnot, which will be really cool. Obviously, there's no iBus as well. That's one thing we're not going to have, obviously, in this video, because the iBuses are going to be mainly implemented for the London map, not for this map and whatnot. I think there are stuff you can still do here, like you can go here and set to Paignton station, but it doesn't actually do anything to the destination display outside, because I think there is font files and stuff for Cotterell, but I don't think there's for like I think all the other things are kind of set for London and whatnot. But you can still do things like this, like you can say you can do that if you really really want to. Anyway, the door's closed. Let's get going on our journey on buses of the West Country. I definitely have enjoyed this map. It's actually really really nice. Actually, one thing. Let me just for curiosity's sake, I'm gonna turn on track IR, because I do kind of want it. You can see that little bit of a glitch there of the transparent texture there. Again, this bus is purely a work in progress still. It's not the final thing, so anything you see that you think, that's not really right with it, it will most likely be fixed or patched. There we go. Nicely does it. Only one route on buses of the West Country. The link as well for the map, I can at least give you guys the link for the map for buses of the West Country. That's something I can do. I cannot give the bus one out. So please don't ask me, oh, can I have the files for this bus, please? Because I've seen like in so many other videos, I was like, oh, can you give me the train simulator? What was it, train simulator? Can you give me the South London Project beta map? Because it's not available anymore, but I know you have it, and can you just, you know, give the map files to me? And I'm like, no. It's not supposed to be distributed. But I can definitely give the link down below for the map, buses of the West Country. I'm running version 2.7. I think the legacy version that's actually available. Let me just the legacy version that's actually available for which I think the legacy version is actually version 2.5. I think 2.7 just rehashes some things and fixes up some kind of major bugs and whatnot. Welcome aboard, guys. There we go. You see, if I just accelerate now from in the drive gear, it takes a quite a long time to actually get moving forward. So that's why I stick it into neutral and rev it and then put it into drive, because then the bus just then goes instantly, which is really nice. I can rehear that Euro 6 engine work. It's a really nice engine. Ooh.
You cannot be serious, man.
Let's go out and have a look at this. I honestly, this bus stop always like gets me, because when normally no one really gets off at this stop. So when you do actually have someone actually come off, it's a bit surprising. Right. Give you some exterior driving, which we won't stay in too long because my track record for exterior driving is very, very, very bad. Going into a 20 speed limit here. Perfect. One thing people do is when you ring the doorbell, you can see actually the LCD screen's actually working up there. It's really cool. When you have people getting off, when you stop the bus, that's when they start walking from the top from the upper deck to the lower deck to actually get out. So you actually have to wait for people to walk and actually come downstairs to actually exit the bus. And as you can see here, the upper the right camera shows the back of the bus, which is actually like a really nice feature actually. So it shows you how like far the car's actually behind you. He's actually pretty close. Right. Let us depart. It's an interesting improvement from the Gemini 2, I have to say. Like, if you guys know how the Gemini 2 looks, from the Gemini 1 to the Gemini 2, I think the looks were very subtly changed, like nothing too big. But definitely with this Gemini 3, you can tell that they went all out with some of the design features, especially the front. The front looks crazy, like just those kind of two-shot pointed like headlights and whatnot. And then the back's just very, I think, very plain in my opinion. It kind of resembles, I feel like most of the buses now are trying to resemble the back of the new Routemaster bus. And like if you look at most of the backs of buses in London nowadays, they have like a very curved back. And nothing really much going on anymore like it used to be. And I feel like all the backs of the buses now kind of look the same. In most cases, that's just my opinion. Someone might totally disagree with that kind of analogy, and you can. My opinion. A nice little tight little cobble street here. I think this is a one-way street system here, where you have to wait till traffic comes through, and then you're only allowed in. And it is a bit tight. I might hit the curb here. It's a very tight street. Very tight cobbled street. There we go. Getting some diverted traffic signs and whatnot. I don't know if actually anyone needs to actually get off there. Let's do the old neutral. Oh, hello, right bus. See, this is the, and you're just gonna go right through me, aren't you? See, that's the normal Gemini 1 B7L, I think, that normally does the route on this map. So we're using it. We're basically, if we're to make this a scenario, we're basically hiring out a Gemini 3 from London. I think there's no one waiting here. I think we just can proceed. Perfect. So one thing I want to alert you guys to is soon for basically updating my future shoutouts and how I'm going to do my future shoutouts. I am going to be creating, and also this is to do as well with I'm going to be creating as well for requests and suggestions and whatnot for videos and whatnot. I'm going to be creating a Google form document thing that you can make online. Like, I'm pretty sure you guys know what I'm talking about. And I'm going to just basically have a thing where you can enter your like name that you want a shout out to, and your link to your channel, any kind of social media you want me to kind of link in my description. And then that's the kind of section that will be for the shoutouts. And then basically for video submissions and video ideas and requests and whatnot, I'll have like a section below that, so people can just kind of put in, like paste in like a link to a workshop scenario or something like that. Maybe a link to a map in OMSI, a bus in OMSI, etc. So just because right now my whole kind of thing with requests and shoutouts is that it's very scattered around. You just have loads of people in the comments just asking me, oh, can I have a shout out? And then it just gets all really muddled up. And the main problem when I was doing that before I kind of paused the shoutouts and whatnot is that it was very hard for me to kind of know who asked for a shout out first, and I was just looking at random videos and picking out people that said, oh yeah, can I have a shout out and whatnot. So I definitely want to make it a bit more organized for myself, in just having a system where I can literally get like submissions and stuff through like Google forms or whatnot. And then that also helps me out for requests, because it would just be nice to have somewhere like where all the requests get put through, and then I can just have like a nice spreadsheet of like stuff of saying, oh yeah, people have someone's requested that, someone's requested this and whatnot. And then it also it would be mean that if you want to request something and also want to shout out, you can do both. Or if you just want to request something, you just can fill out the request part. Or if you just want a shout out, you can just fill out the shout out section part.
Jesus, that was close.
No, it wasn't. That was a beautifully executed turn. Obviously, you don't know how to drive a bus. There was actually a Buses of the West Country livery that I could have used for this bus, but I think more people want to see the London red variant, in all honesty. Oh, I mean, let's find a good, oh god. That will do. I don't know what these transparent holes are. I don't know if this is actually a glitch with the bus, and if it is a glitch with a bus, it will be fixed for the main game, or if it's probably a glitch with my game. Because my game is pretty corrupted. Well, not corrupted, but just, like, I don't know what's going on with my game. Right. Do detect some suburban country road driving now coming up ahead, which should be a bit interesting because this engine is kind of designed more for the London city and not really for the suburban drive. I'm sure it'll do fine. The next video I'm going to be doing on the return leg, when I utilize the city bus 400R, I'm going to use one of the versions that has like a really nice engine, and it's like, I think it's called like the Super Regional Express variant, and that engine sounds really good, and I think you guys are going to really like it when I do it in that video. Oh, but this engine has some pep to it actually. And I like how the signage actually tells you like how far away the buses and whatnot are, the bus stops are. So I can improve my braking game. Thank you, welcome aboard. Yeah, you can see these I literally do not know what these things are. I have no idea. It's quite distracting when you do look at them. So I'll just try not to. But I do love the detail of this bus though. It was a very, I think it was a good move to kind of include this bus in instead of the SRM. But I'm pretty sure after the release of the OMSI London, it's still going to get heavily like updated and whatnot, and things like, I think extra buses and whatnot in the future will be added. And now I took that turn really fast. But extra buses will be added in the future. I'm pretty sure like the SRM was already modeled out, so it won't be in the release, but it will be somewhere down the line as like an extra bus. There we go. I think this is a timing point, which I don't think I have my, I don't know where my timetable is, so I can't really check if I'm on time or not. I think I'm slightly late. But the model of this bus looks really good. If you know what I mean, the look of this bus in terms of the front, like with the Gemini being the Gemini 3, it's definitely a very bold change from the Gemini 2 and the 1. You can see there's another little glitch there with the lights from the for the staircase to the upper deck show through the for the exterior. That will definitely get rectified. Right. Let's go. The LED lights are actually really good as well. And this map is actually really, really good. It's a really good drive, this fact. I've driven out a few times now, like in testing of like testing the bus and the route and whatnot. And I have to say, it's a really nicely built route. Really good length. Good variety of of like suburban and urban driving sections and whatnot. It's not all the same kind of thing. The scenery is actually decent as well. And I do believe Buses of the West Country 2 is like the project that they're working on now. I think it's Fellow Sims or the UK DT team are working on Buses of the West Country 2, and that will basically just extend this map and I think add a few more bus lines. I'm pretty sure. I'm looking forward to that. Because it's not many good left-hand drive maps out there, to be honest, I'm not going to lie. And it's nice that, you know, stuff like OMSI London now is going to hopefully pave the way for, like, really good quality left-hand drive maps. And obviously buses, like some of these buses, like this bus, the 400, the Enviro 400, or the Citybus 400, I really should just call it the Citybus, but I have the tendency of just calling it Enviro still. But those buses are really good, really well made. And you'll see, definitely I think my favourite is the Citybus so far. I mean the Citybus 400 so far, compared to this one. This one's good. But I do like the Citybus 400 a little more. But this is a really good, like, you know, really good bus add-on. If we're just looking at the bus itself. Sorry. Ooh. I think I just denched the, I'm gonna let people off. I don't know if people will get back on. right. You can get off. But, sorry guys. I, overshot that. Apologize. My fault. Sorry, the next bus will be along in like 20 minutes or something like that. It's really bad of me. But hey, we all do mistakes, don't we? Most of the time I am the perfect bus driver, but you know, you can't keep that perfection up all the time. You gotta let it slip a few times. Bus stop in 140 yards. Thank you. And do we... Yes, we have someone. Ooh. Is it just someone? I think it's just someone getting on. Welcome aboard. I think we actually have to do a sharp right turn here. So we have to do a full lock. Well, not actually a full lock, to be honest. That was three and a half quarter turn lock. But I love the acoustics and stuff of the engine that you hear in the interior. It's really good. Left here. And taking a right, where can we go from here? Totnes, Newton Abbot, Plymouth, Torquay. I don't know if these are some of the places that you'll be able to drive in buses of the West Country too. I don't know how far they said that they were going to actually extend it, I'm not too sure. I'm not too knowledgeable about buses of the West Country, I have to say. Tony, it's a fairly new map for me. And back down to 30 miles per hour. The boring speed limit. Or as they say, the safe speed limit. Move down inside the bus. Let's play it.
Please move down inside the bus.
Like a boss. Right. Doors closed. Ooh, are we going? Where are we going? Yeah, I completely ignored the sign. Going straight, okay. Even though the actual road sign says Paignton's to the left, we actually have to go straight forward. So if I was just using my road sign knowledge there, then I would have gone the wrong way. Ooh, love these roundabouts. Love them. It's a bit of a squeeze with these kind of buses. It's quite a wide bus, I have to say. There's some places in London where, like, it's incredible some of the places that these buses actually squeeze into. Absolutely crazy. Actually, I didn't really have to even open the back door, though, because no one's getting off. Off we go. I'm really looking forward to driving the new Routemaster bus. That is something I don't know if any tester has actually. I'm pretty sure there are a few testers that have actually tried the new Routemaster bus, but I've not tried it yet, and I'm eagerly looking forward to trying that one. Because obviously that utilizes the hybrid system, where, like, say your acceleration, when you accelerate, there's no like engine torque, that's just electric power, and then the engine kicks in after like a certain speed, which I'm looking. I think I did try a hybrid. I think there was a hybrid bus that I did try, or I think I tested out the hybrid Enviro 400. I think, yeah, this was actually quite some time ago. I did actually test the hybrid version of it, and it wasn't that well scripted. I think. I don't think the hybrid version is actually being made of the Enviro 400. I'm not too sure. Maybe it is. But that was quite a long time ago when I was testing that. I want you to be a little bit slow here. Come on, we need to keep in the speed limit here. But 30 is slow. But I'm a good bus driver. I do like the indicator sound. Low temperature, I think. Where is the. Can I. No, I think this is something that's not implemented yet, is the heater controls. I don't think it's scripted yet into the game, so I can't actually edit or configure the. The heat in the bus. So sorry, passengers, you're gonna just have to be cold for this journey. I do apologize. Going straight over the little mini roundabout. Like, everyone in this town of Paignton and Totnes just seeing a red London bus driving through, and they're thinking, what is this? It's fascinating how London actually adopts the whole red colour London, like, red colour bus scheme. So, like, all the, basically, when I look at, or maybe when any kind of, like, say, tourist or just a normal person that's not really into buses, when they look at a bus in London, they would say all the buses are the same, pretty much, because they're all red. And you can't really distinguish what bus operating company is actually actually operating them, unless you're a very keen-eyed person. Like, obviously, you'd be like, you'd spot the logo or whatever straight away. But not everyone can do that. So it's fascinating how all the buses are just purely red in London, and in other places around the country, you know, you can tell. Oh yeah, that's a stagecoach bus. That's a first bus. That's you know, an Arriva bus and whatnot. But in London, it's just everything's equal. But I remember the time when you got some differences, which I, let me just squeeze over into this lane. I'm a bit naughty here. But I actually remember back in the day when there was actually subtle differences between bus operating companies. Like, you know, your Metro line had a blue stripe at the base. London United had like grey at the base of the bus and at the top of the bus. Things like Stagecoach had the kind of full kind of Stagecoach thing. Basically, it was the same kind of design as all the other designs outside in the. Oh my god, look at that car, what the hell are you doing? It had the same design as all the other Stagecoach kind of liveries around the country, and but it was just all red instead of all white, which was really cool. London General had like really nice dark grey strips at the bottom, and I think at the top of the bus and whatnot. And it was, I like those little subtle differences that distinguished each kind of bus operating company, and you don't get that anymore. It's just all red. I think the only thing that now really distinguishes bus operating companies is the interior, really, to be honest. And if you actually look at, if I showed you, I don't think I can, but if you actually looked at the list of liveries and stuff for this bus in this game, and when you're actually picking out the liveries, there's no difference in the exterior, it's all the interior. Except for the London Sovereign and London United bus, which I'm driving the London Sovereign bus, those have just all red and don't have any kind of black kind of patches and whatnot, which distinguishes them. We are here at Paignton Zoo. I really like this kind of like loop in into the kind of zoo area, and both return and to and from journeys come through the same stop. So you could either wait here for a bus to go to Paignton or a bus to go to Totnes, which is pretty cool. Welcome on board, guys. Now, why aren't they getting on? Oh, I think it's because the bus is full. No, the bus isn't full. There's space. It's really odd. I'm looking at those like invisible transparent things. They look really weird. They look like hovering discs here, like portal discs. Anyway, they're not coming on. I'm just gonna leave them to their own demise. And I'm back in my cab because I can't drive in the exterior. Taking a left, a right here. Jesus, my. Oh my god. I think I'm like sidlexic or something, or dyslexic maybe. But no, I'm not reading anything. It's just, I don't know if there's like a condition for like not being able to distinguish your left and right properly, because I think I have that condition. Because I'm always just like, always when I'm driving an OMSI, I'm just like, yeah, I'm gonna take a right now, which no, I'm taking a left. But it doesn't affect like my kind of motory skill, like motory senses, where I'm like actually having to turn left or turn right. It's just thinking it or saying it, it affects me. So I'd say the wrong way by just thinking about it, but not actually doing it, because my brain, well. Part of my brain that's actually controlling where I'm turning and whatnot knows that's left and knows that's right, but my part of my brain that's actually saying if it's left or right is a bit confused. Right. I think we had someone wanting to get off there, I'm not too sure. Thank you, welcome aboard. And this ticket machine as well is fully functional, like you can just tap in something, and enter, maybe, no? There, you press the red button. I don't know. That will be implemented for London more than here it is, like more in this map. Look at these people crossing the road. Crazy bastards. I wasn't going to stop for that. In a totally illegal place. Is someone getting off? Yeah, they are. Shuffle through a bit of the cameras. There we go. deals really nice in the interior. And are we? Oh, yep, we're upstairs. Okay, you can see I can look down the stairs. Ibus there, nicely. Just signifying that we're going 35 to Paignton. So you can see that I've inputted everything. Just the destination blinds are not working. Why not? Everything so far has been pretty smooth in this return, semi-return. Need to put in the semi. The semi-return to OMSI, not too bad. Things have not been too stressful so far. And this bus is a nice little treat to drive. Perfect. Someone getting off here, yes. Nice pop out slide out doors. Are these guys gonna get on? They're not. Nah. You don't get pedestrians that just walk randomly and go, oh yeah, I wanna hop on the bus. Man, those doors really slam shut right at the end there. Do you believe we're in Paignton now? I think. Well, somewhere in the outskirts or just going through it. And then Paignton station somewhere. But I don't think there's a bus stop right on the station concourse. I think the bus stop's like separate to where the station is. But you'll see what I mean once we actually get there. A lot of people though coming on, you know. Pretty busy service. Oh, someone wants to get off. You see, you have to wait for people to actually walk from the upstairs to downstairs, or they'll come down and they'll ring the bell to try and get off. Which I like that. That's very London-esque. Because like the amount of times I've been on a bus and literally the bus driver's closing the doors and there's someone running down, and I've even done it myself, you know. I've been that one where the doors are closing and I run down like, can you let me off please? I'm going to stop a little bit more forward here so the back doors have some clearance. Yeah, there you go. See, normally in a normal bus here, you would just stop right here because obviously there's no back door, but obviously because we're driving a London variant bus, there is a back door, so we have to take that into consideration. Oh, I like that bit of graffiti there of buses on the wall. Very nice. And I can leave my indicator on because we are actually turning right. Hyde Road. You go again a little bit more forward so I can give some clearance to the back door. And I'm actually quite away from the pavement. That's nice. I hope there's going to be more British maps and whatnot in the future, because I do like driving on them, and you guys like watching me drive on British maps and whatnot. And my most like viewed videos are pretty much British maps. Like all my like South London Project Beta map videos is like some of my highest views on my channel. It's like so crazy. So you guys love when I do anything related with London. Like even my BV videos. Crazy. I mean, the first video of that's like somewhere near 60,000 views. That's crazy. Just going straight here. And I do believe now the garage, depot, garage, whatever you call it, it's come up here on the left, and that's where we'll be starting in the return leg when we drive in the Citybus 400R on the way back in the next video that I'll do. Thank God for the traffic light that's up ahead, because I hate, like, I think it's mostly in European kind of cities and whatnot that you get traffic lights only here, and you don't get any traffic lights up ahead to actually, like, say if you come up to it and you have, like, if the traffic light's blind to you, like if it's in a blind spot or something, it's always nice having a traffic light that's a little bit further out so you can, you know, you can see. Is that Aldi over there? I think it is. Yeah, this is a bit of a funny glitch. Now to our left, we'll have Paignton Station come up, and I think if it is there, and I think it should be there, you'll see a pacer. Filthy thing. Filthy thing over there.
Jesus, Gavno, what the hell's going on with your driving?
Sorry, this is really to take that turn quite sharp. But anyway, we're here, I do believe. This is Paignton Bus Station. We're turning now. It's one of these bus stations where you just pull up into a rank. Number two is our allocated thing. If I now stop. we'll just pretend that there was no fence there. We just, you know, we're a little bit careless. Right. And give me my time. I'm not going to say what I was, but I was okay. Oh, has the nice authentic reversing sounds and whatnot. But anyway, guys, we are here. We have arrived at Paignton in our Gemini 3 bus. I hope you guys have enjoyed it. I have. It is a semi-return to OMSI, but hopefully I can. OMSI can be nice to me, and I will then be able to do some videos for you guys. I actually didn't even notice that there's some nice sunscreen. Roof sunscreen things up there, which is very cool. I didn't even notice this in real life, but that's really nice. They should have done it all the way through. That would have just given so much natural light into the bus. That'd be crazy. But this is the beta. It's a work in progress. Gemini 3 for the OMSI London Addon map. It is not the final representation that will be in the actual add-on. but it is just a work in progress version I was allowed to show you guys today. Hope you guys enjoyed it. It was a nice drive, a refreshing drive on buses of the West Country version 2.7. I will leave the link down for the map below. Please do not ask me where you get this bus from, because it's only available to beta testers. And soon OMSI London will be upon us, and then soon I'll be able to do videos with all the buses, including the new route master with this bus, as well as the Enviro 400 as well. Shoutouts again go to DurpyPigGaming and Howach. That's again DurpyPigGaming and Howach. The links to stuff will be down below. Please do show them some love. Keep your eye out for the Google form document that I will be creating, and having like basically new shoutouts and stuff, requests and whatnot, processed through. So people that haven't had shoutouts can then now submit things through that once I set that up, and I'll let you guys know. I'll probably do an individual video for that. So keep posted with that. I'll probably like post it on Facebook as well as a video on YouTube and whatnot. So keep up to date with the channel. Stay tuned. Other than that, I hope you've enjoyed it. This bus is fantastic, very detailed, very good, very nice, and I'm just excited and eager to play it on OMSI London. Buses of the West Country 2 has been a really nice map as well. I really do like Route 35, and I can't wait to do the return journey in the Citybus 400R. I will see you for that next video shortly. Take care, guys. Have a nice day. We ain't